Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about formic field array. So we have already talked about formic, form, field, error message tag. So the next one is field array. Okay, so sometimes we need to create a dynamic forms based on the data input, like you are getting some kind of array, you wanted to iterate onto that array and wanted to render the same number of input fields. In that case, this field array will be helpful. Okay, so our final objective of all these exercises is to create a pure dynamic form from JSON template. So you will be receiving this JSON template where you will have a label, type can be input, select, checkbox, radio button, and we will be building a form with all different kind of validations, all different kind of options, all these custom validations will be there. This is our final objective. So that we can achieve by just talking about the field array, dynamic form creations and all. So this is the first thing which we are talking is field array. Okay, so this is our previous example we have created. So what I will do is I will just clean this up. We don't need all these fields. So I'm going to have values something like this. I'm going to have only name and email, and this is the initial value I have, and I want form to populate all these values. So if I have like friends array length 10, then 10 form field pairs should be there with the name and email, right? And if I add something new from action, then I should be able to populate the new text fields for name and email. This is dynamic form, right? Based on user action, we are creating the new form field with all different kind of validation and all. Currently we are just taking care of the input type text. It can be input type email, password, range, date picker, can be checkbox, can be radio button, radio group, anything, select box, right? Okay, so initial values, we are initializing something like this. So we have friends array. So I will, initial values is friends array. Okay, now what we are going to do is, we have the validation schema, which is here, form schema. So what we are going to do, we will fix this validation schema. This will not work for the field array because here we have an array attribute. On submit, we'll see what we are getting. Just print values here. And there are many ways of writing it. So either you write this render function. Okay. So I will just talk about it. So here I think we missed one closing. Okay, so either you write a render function, in the render function you define all these things like we are getting props and all, or you can also do one thing in the close the formic tag and define everything as a children. So this approach we are using, you know, defining everything in the render. So this we got. Now what we are going to use inside a form, we are going to use field array. So we'll just remove everything. And we are going to use field array, and field array will have its own render mechanism. So we will use that. So inside form, we have a field array. Field array will have name, a simple property, just a placeholder. Okay, after this, we are going to have, we have to iterate on something, right? So we will have a render function. In this field array, this is a property, and inside the field array we will get all these properties inside it, so which we can access through the props. Let me just see. Okay, this is initial curly braces, and here we will do the destructuring. Okay, in the destructuring we can define all the methods which we are passing, and here we will render our form. Okay, so field array will close here. Okay, let's render something. Okay, it's already returning, so we don't need to return. Yeah, this is fine now. So what we can render here is we have to loop onto this array. We got the initial values, right, which is a friends array. So what we will do is we will loop onto the friends array and we will render our form. Okay, so what checks we can do here is, In this case, we can just create a div, and inside div we can define all our form. So here again, this process, and what we are doing is we are just checking props values we are getting. Here we are also getting values, so we are accessing values dot friends dot map. So values dot friends, if it is there, then we will just loop onto it. Friends dot map, and pretty much. So here we will be just looping onto individual friend and index, and we will render our JSX here. Okay, this is going to be a little complex because it is nested. Okay, here. Now we will be rendering each and every form field. Okay, so I will just put a one placeholder so that we can go forward. So what this is going to return is this we will put here. So this is what it is returning. So if we are writing it like this, then we have to put a return, and in the return this is what we are returning for each and every friend. Format it and let's see. So here friend index, and this is the field. So everything else is kind of same. So here we are just rendering on friends array. We are just checking if friends array had some values. If not, then we are just stop there. If we got some values inside a friends array, then we are running a map on it. Okay, we are getting index, so we can actually define key also for each and every child. And we are accessing the friends array. So here for each and every friend, we are able to access the values. Okay, here we are just creating these properties. Friends name, because name should be unique for each and every field. So here we are creating input type text field. So errors.friends, now errors will also be customized based on the array index. Errors.friend index, based on the name property, and if it is invalid or if this particular field has been touched in that case. So we are actually rendering this particular form. Similarly, there are two fields actually. We can have a two fields. This is first field. We can actually create an outside wrapper around it, because there are two fields. One is name and number one is email. So let's create one wrapper, and then we can have these two fields, two columns around it. Okay, this is talking about input type email, and it should be email. So all the other properties you can change, all the touch property, email validation. Okay, so this is how we have created a dynamic form based on the input array. Now you can have some kind of a push method using which you will be adding the new entries. There is some validation error, I think. So this div is not closed. Okay, things are good now. This become little too much nested, right? Because here we are in the rendering, we can define our methods like insert, push, pop. If you wanted to add a new friends, and here in the bottom there can be one method using which you can add a new friend. Okay, something like this. So what we are doing is here we are doing push on click, and we are calling this push method, and we are adding the new form values. So like initially there were some values, and now we are doing push on that. Okay, so this is pretty much we have. Now we will actually clean this up, and we can also use the insert, update, remove methods. In the next video we'll try to more optimize it. Here it is looking like a lot of other things are happening, right? So in the field array it has its render function. Inside render function we are iterating onto the arrays and then returning the JSX for each and every form field. Okay, thanks everyone.